When it comes to manifestation, you don't attract what you want. You attract what you entertain, okay? So if you're entertaining something that you say you don't want, for instance, let's just say you want a spouse, you want a mate, all right? If you want a, you know, you want this man, you want a man with a good job and an income, and, you know, he's rough around the edges, and he's a real, you know what I'm saying, stand-up guy, and he takes care of the household, and he's a good family man, and everybody loves him, he gets respect, you know, he'll protect you, he's a leader, and then you're entertaining you're entertaining guys that are the exact opposite of what you're saying you want in a man. Unbeknownst to you, you are continuing to attract the ones that you are entertaining in likewise, in like-minded energy. Because you are telling the universe, because this is what you got in front of you, this right here. You're saying, hey, I want this. But this is how the universe sees. See, the universe don't know about the past, present, your expectation, who good, who bad, or nothing like that. Because the mind doesn't operate like this. Excuse me. The mind is not aware of that, which is connected to the universe. Your brain is connected to your physical body. So your brain and your ego, your physical, you may want, or you may be entertaining this energy because you don't want to be lonely. But you don't realize if you're willing to sacrifice making yourself so available and entertaining things that you say you don't want, when you start showing the universe, I am shutting this down. I'm not entertaining it no longer. I may not entertain anything for a while. Eventually, if you start saying, you know what, I like that kind of guy, or that's the kind of guy I want right there, or let me Google some, let me start to even manifest the perfect guy. Let me write it down. See, I ain't started manifesting no dude yet, all right? I haven't manifested my God because I know I'm looking for a God. Like, I want to be really, really specific with my manifestations because I know I'm able to manifest things, all right? So I have to be really particular about how I structure my manifestations. Writing things down is a good way to start working on a manifestation. Ladies, if you remember when you was younger, probably a lot of you done this, and I'm gonna show y'all exactly how manifestation works because you may be able to resonate with this. When I was younger, I used to have a list of all these things that I wanted in a guy, and I had a list of things that I wouldn't settle for, like I wasn't going for it. If he didn't have all these qualities, he didn't qualify. All right, well, as I got older and as I started, you know, dating and getting involved with the guys, I started feeling like, dang, this perfect description of what I want may never come. So what happened? I started settling for what I was getting. I started settling for what I seen. I started settling for what I was around. Because for one thing, I wasn't even putting myself in the right type of environments to attract them because they have gotten better with their tactics, their skill, and their technology. All right. So let's get back to the indigenous people of this land, the Aborigines, and why we are not from Africa. Most of y'all don't understand. They don't want you to know that your ancestors was from over here, all right? Because if they did, then you would know that they stole everything from us and that they really owe you everything. That's why they're not going to give out no reparations. That's not going to happen, all right? And the ancestors told me to tell y'all that. If it do happen, it probably is in 2 or 3, 6, 7, 10 years from now. What's going to happen is we're going to have to take our shit back, all right? We're going to have to take back what's ours. It ain't no, oh, we finna give you this and give you that. You better get what the fuck they giving out and figure out how to repair your own self and your own community and your own family from within. Because they're not going to give it to you. People like, well, how they giving the Chinese these people this? And how they give Indian people this? And how they give these people this? And how they get them? Because those people are not born and they're not owned by this corporation over here that these people are calling America. We don't even realize these people stealing us from the get-go, man. As soon as we born, we're signing a contract. That birth certificate is a fucking life contract. It's a soul contract on our life. We're signing our kids over to this corporation that we call America. The same one that our oppressors came and stole from us. So we thinking that we're born free because it's not 1905 anymore. But we don't realize, no, you're still born into slavery. They're still birthing you and making you a slave from jump. We don't understand why we're so oppressed and can't get up. The spirit's hanging heavy on our hearts and our bodies because they're hanging heavy on our souls. And then what they do, they send you to school and they tell you, learn how to spell. Because you don't realize that spelling is the first fucking thing they teach you. Ever wonder why they teach you spelling? You think because you're supposed to be able to talk and know how to pronounce words and know the meanings of them, right? But did you know our people back in the day, we didn't speak words? Did y'all know that? Y'all know who taught us words? Yeah, you're right. You're colonizers. Same one got niggas out here sagging their pants. Don't even know that represents a nigga been buck broken by his slave master. All right? So they do a lot.